only mode.
Hey guys, can everyone hear me tonight? If you just want to raise your hand, then we can make sure we are good to go and ready to rock the house. Awesome. All right. So I have for the longest time wanted to do a fun class like this. Just to introduce myself, my name is Rachel Feldman. Some of you know me, some of you do not. But one thing that I always say is, and I was actually telling a few people today, one being a copywriter, another person I was talking to was an editor. I happen to be just talking about how I created my business. And I said, you know, it's no BS that I really came out of school and I had no idea what Dropbox was. I didn't even know there was a system for holding documents. I didn't know what MailChimp was. I heard Constant Contact in school when I attended the Institute for Integrative Nutrition. Had no idea what it meant to build a list, except that I knew I should do it. And then I got out of school and I had no moolah, no cash, because we had lost everything in the stock market and we had owned our home. So we sold that so we could live. And that was actually the beginning. That was literally the beginning of my career as a health coach. We sold our house. We moved from Philadelphia, where I knew tons of people and was going to feel very comfortable in a health coaching practice, to a place where I knew nobody, which was Florida. And I really knew nobody. So I had to learn this and I had to figure it out. And it was not easy. But I think that it is not only I think it, I believe 100%, it's the foundation of how your business grows. You can either have an opt-in freebie, you can have a video opt-in freebie, you can have many different types of opt-in freebies. It's what you're opting into when you go to somebody's site, because you're probably not going to just give them your email because they say sign up for my newsletter. People think of that as spam. So if you're sitting here listening and you're saying, I don't have any money like you, Rach, at that time, I need to make some money and I want to make this health coaching gig, you know, a full-time practice, you have to build your list. And you have to build your list either with an opt-in freebie on a website. You can do it at events. You can do it networking. But still, people have to want to give you their email. And not just because you want to do an event and you want to get their email. You want to have interaction with people. So the big thing that happens when you don't have interaction is, one, people don't get to know who you are, which means they're probably not going to then end up hiring you. But two, you want to be able to have them on a list so that when you are doing giveaways or when you are offering cleanses or one-on-one coaching or strategy sessions, you have a list to communicate. Because if you don't, how can you create that trust, that communication with people? So what we're going to do tonight is go through how to build a list and rock out a freebie in a very easy way. No, I'm not a tech master. I'm not a tech genius. I'm not a graphic designer. I'm none of that. I'm just literally a chick who has figured out how to do stuff on her own, and you can be the same too. So often we get like really stuck in our business because we're depending on a designer, a webmaster, a virtual assistant. In the beginning, I had none of those. And still, even today, when something is a problem, I know how to go in and fix Dropbox. I know how to go in and fix MailChimp. I know what to do with my own stuff. And I want you to have the same thing, because if you see someone else having success, it's yours for the taking as well. The only difference between having success or not having success is just that pure empowerment of knowing how to do something. So I am a health coach. I did attend the Institute for Integrative Nutrition. I did attend some different detoxification schools thereafter, because I believe that clean eating is not enough. Unfortunately, it's very sad that we live in a world like this, not just the United States. I have many clients all across the country in other parts of the world who are suffering with autoimmune and hormonal issues and all these different things that are happening because we just live in a pretty toxic world with people who tend to have toxic thinking and we're never unplugged from the computer and all that jazz, which is why we have to be health coaches. But I went to detox school because I really do believe, and every different one that I attended had a different theory on detoxification. But at the root cause of our health issues is massive inflammation. It's just massive, whether it's hidden or whether you see it as a rash or allergies or psoriasis, you know, on your body, something of that nature. I'm a wellness advocate because I say that I believe, one, I do love essential oils. I do love natural solutions, but an advocate just means that I stand up and I say why. I don't just accept, well, you have this. Detox specialist, business strategist. I help people to really come out of stuck places in their business. I don't have a 7-step, you know, get better and build your business and get 50 clients in X days. I don't have that system. The system that I have is build your shit from the ground up because that is what's going to get you success. And it is going to be hard, but you can do it. And so I teach people how to build from ground zero because that's exactly what I did. I'm a proud mama to 2 little ones. They keep me going. They're 6 and 8 and they are little mission makers because they've grown up with a mom who has told them that they have to speak up in this world because we live in that toxic world full of, you know, cereal boxes that are promising us like heart health. It's kind of sad. And I am a 6-figure business owner, and I don't tell you this to say like, wow, I'm a 6-figure business owner. I tell you this because, you know, my husband's business did not come back from the stock market. And so today I do support my family. I support all of us, our bills, everything, the emergency front door that need to be replaced for $3,000. I do all of that from health coaching, and you can too. And I built my business with a site from the Institute for Integrative Nutrition. I knew all these people who are going off to get $4,000, $5,000 sites, and I built it with that site and a list. And at the time I was using Constant Contact. What I will say is right here, what do you need essentials for your business? So at the time I would use Constant Contact, but it's not as effective for list building and for tracking. You want to use your list also to nail down your niche. What is your niche? Really the people that you want to work with that have a specific or many specific problems, and you're helping them with those problems because that's your specific niche. That's your target market. So this happens by also having opt-in freebies. Because when you have an opt-in freebie, you can start to look at your newsletters, the opens, the list, and see how many are opting in to that. And again, you could have a video, you could have, and we're going to actually look at the opt-in freebie that I'm going to give you guys as well. You can have this opt-in freebie. The idea is you don't want to just put this free on your site. Free content is vital to build your search engine optimization. Don't let somebody rob you for a lot of money on search engine optimization. You can do it for yourself for free by really tagging things well on blogs and everything. But you definitely need to have a website, whether it's a Weebly. I'll even write this in here because I wish somebody would have done this. Oops, that could spell. Weebly, Wix, or, you know, an InSight or WordPress. That is a little more difficult, in my opinion, to get started on your own. Weebly, I created one with a coach the other day in screen sharing during our Skype call. Literally, we created it in like 20 minutes. Wix is the same. So you need to have a website. Don't need to have a lot of money. Again, I want to empower you so that you can go and sell programs and sell your services. But you need to have a site because you want to have someone to be able to come to your site. Yes, you can have an opt-in freebie and feel free to ask questions as well. You can have an opt-in freebie just on your Facebook business page. You can have an opt-in freebie that you promote on different and all areas of social media. Yes, today we're going to use MailChimp, but there's Aweber, there's Mad Mimi. There's Constant Contact. There are a lot of different ones. For me, I find that MailChimp is is as of it, Constant Contact was easy. MailChimp was just more effective for what I needed to do, which was really to grow my business. You want to have your opt-in freebie? Somebody say, am I sharing a screen? Yes, I'm sharing a screen. So if you can't, can everyone else see my screen? If you can just say yes, that would, okay. So if Debbie, if you can't see my screen, maybe try to log out, log back in. But I will tell you, it will be recorded. We're recording this baby, so we are good. And I'm sorry if you're having issues. Sometimes I really do think tech is a total B in the butt. Anyway, we need to have an opt-in freebie. Social media, you don't have to become like a social media maven, but I will tell you, get down and dirty with understanding at least one or two platforms. I still to this day don't know how to Twitter. I should be 14, not 40. And I'd probably be really great at Twittering or tweeting or whatever you want to say, whatever verb and adjective. But you have to build a presence, especially if you want to be offline, and especially if you want to be online. You still need to build a presence, because even offline, how are you going to promote, you know, your events? You want to have, you know, an opt-in freebie somewhere. So even if you're doing more one-on-one coaching events, groups that are local or in your home, still need that opt-in freebie. Still got to build your list to get people to figure out what the heck you do so they want to sign up with you. So I always say with social media, whether it's Facebook or Instagram, which I love, or Pinterest, you know, Google Plus, make sure you're on one of them sharing your magic. Twitter, of course, we all know that. Marketing 101, you know, this is the thing. Somebody asked me yesterday, actually, they said, oh my God, whoever does your marketing is really good. And I said, oh, it's me, myself, and Irene. And she started laughing. She said, I didn't know the three of you work together. I said, well, the three of us have worked together for a long time, except for the copy, the words that you often see on my sales pages, like at detox.rachelswellness.com or my personal, Spring Detox. I think I even wrote the majority of that. But other than that, the marketing that you see in the morning on Rachel's Wellness during the day, that's just me. So big thing with marketing, my friends, is be yourself. Like, don't try to be anyone else's brand. Don't try to be anybody else's, you know, anything but you. That's really your marketing. There's not like, there is a system of marketing. It took me a long time to learn how to write an opt-in freebie, which is why in all the Done For You programs, I put opt-in freebies in there, because a lot of people, and if you're one of them on the phone right now who says, oh my God, it takes me like an hour to write a blog, or, you know, it takes me forever. I just get stuck. I can't finish. I can't edit my documents and get a program out there. If you're that person, then you know that the writing is tough for you, and this is where you want help. So that's why I make sure that like their opt-in freebies always in the programs, or suggestions on how to do it, or blogs, because for some of us, this is where we really get stuck. Marketing, like I said, just be yourself, but be consistently with a message. Content in your blog, repurpose. I think it took me 4 years and 4 years and 3 months in my business, and I'm at like 5 years. To repurpose and to realize that the content on my blog, you know, really can be just a mirror image of other content that I have. So many of you, whether you've bought programs from me, or you've bought programs from someone else, or you just have a crap load of material sitting on your desktop, repurpose, use it, recipes, share, start, you know, putting that information. And at the bottom of that blog, the bottom of that content, that's when you link also and say, wanted to share this awesome, you know, e-guide, you know, on XYZ. Wanted to share my brand new spanking awesome, you know, ebook on XYZ. So you always want to be, you know, giving great content and then showing them to the water. And this is, you know, I don't look at it as like a close. I hate people who do real salesy stuff. It maybe because I was in sales for so long and never was my style anyway. I like people that come in with like that soft, like, hey, how are you going? Here, click this cool thing. So however it works for you, make it work, but do it, because at the end of somebody reading something, you have their attention. You've pulled them in. So they want to click. They want to give you their email. Programs and offerings. This was a biggie for me. My business boomed, and I always say this, when I started to have a system in place. So as I said to you earlier, I don't have this like 7-point system, get X, Y, Z. I don't roll like that. But I do have a system for my clients, and it's a system that's based on the elimination diet, cleansing, clean eating, and also a system that allows me to not have to like jump over to 50 different places for recipes, because I have different programs that have recipes, and those are the ones that you see at detox.rachelswellness.com. I use those. But also what the programs did for me is when somebody would opt in, I would be able in my opt-in to say, you know, I'm going to be launching a program in the spring. I'm going to be doing a free giveaway. You use your opt-ins as almost like candy at the candy store. Like you walk in and or you know, standing in front of a bakery and they're handing out donuts. They're just giving you a treat that's going to taste so good. So then you want to understand more. Is everyone with me on this? Understanding kind of like why we have opt-ins and that they don't just like sit there. I have also probably about 70 opt-ins at this point, or maybe like, yeah, probably about 70. I use them in all different ways because everyone's different. I also want to see who is my niche. Sometimes we have a very specific niche. And it's really, that's not it. I never thought I would do weight loss, ever. Never really had a weight issue except when this boy cheated on me when I was like 15, 16 or something with a girl that I used to swim competitively with. And I think I gained 30 pounds. And that wasn't fun. And yes, I did gain 80 pounds with my first pregnancy. And that wasn't fun. But never did I think I would be a weight loss coach. But my niche started getting defined because people they didn't want tips on digestion. They wanted to know why they were having weight issues. So often my opt-in freebies are a clear insight into what's trending, what do people want, how can I get to know them better, because I can see open rates. So we're going to hook up a freebie today. Why are you doing a freebie? Can everyone just scream and say, because we want to build our damn list. That is why. So when I say juicy, interesting, like for some people, it has to be something sexy on the front, like 10 smoothies that will get your body back into shape, or 10, you know, sinful smoothies, or whatever you want to name it. That's marketing. You know, people know that I curse a little. We talk a lot of slang, and I say like a lot. That just happens to be me. And if I tried to be anyone else, I really would have a problem in my business, because I don't think anyone would hire me, because I wouldn't be sounding like myself. So whatever you want to name your opt-in freebie or the marketing leading up to your opt-in freebie, make it sound like you. Often we pick these like finite words that don't really sound like us, and then people don't really get to know us. The whole idea of an opt-in freebie is for someone to get to know you. So the format of your freebie, PDF is great. You know, sometimes we want to do it longer than 10 pages because that's our intention and our goal. So always think of your opt-in freebie as, what is my intention with this? What is my goal? And where do I want to drive people to? Also, have in mind, what is that follow-up to the opt-in freebie, which is why in all the programs that I create, we have follow-up letters for those opt-in freebies. Because you really want to think, what is that continual conversation that you're having? You don't want to have an opt-in freebie that someone downloads and it's completely different than your business. It doesn't even make any sense. You know, say you have like this, you know, how to go vegan opt-in freebie, but you're like a paleo coach. that promotes like eating bacon all the time. You can be a paleo coach and be vegan, of course, but you know, those two things wouldn't vibe. So just make sure you can test your market all the time, but make sure it's got that common theme that you're really working for. This is a great example. One of my good friends, Lisa Consiglio, I love her work. I love her also as just a woman, her authenticity. And I encourage you to go and actually to her site and download other people's opt-in freebies. It's a great example, like right here, as you see, it's a great place. Now, if you're not able to do that, because again, you may not have a VA, you may not have, you know, a designer, make sure that you have that box somewhere that's easy for people to get to. She has it in two different places. You can put it at the bottom. You can say sign up for a strategy session or grab, you know, my free e-guide, which will give you a sneak peek into what it's like working with me. Bam. Where to market? Facebook business pages, Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, exactly all the things that we talked about earlier. So why do we include opt-in freebies, you know, with this, whether it's doTERRA, Rockstar, Revitalize? And you can see, like, here is an opt-in freebie, smoothie slim down book. Here's another opt-in freebie, another opt-in freebie, another one, another one. Because you want people to come to your site and download something that's A, visually nice, but two, is also going to serve them. And three, many of the opt-in freebies that I also use can be turned into either mini challenges or giveaways, especially with doTERRA. You know, the intention is you're leading them to want to understand more about oils. So this is going to, you know, be the perfect opt-in freebie. If you're selling, you know, a work with me program that's about weight loss or clean eating or detoxing or getting rid of emotional, you know, junk or revamping your house or, you know, get all these different things, revamping your house with good foods, I mean, then you want to make sure that you're naming whatever opt-in freebie you have to align with that. Does that make sense to everyone? Okay, so let's move on to actually doing an opt-in freebie. All right. So this is one, I just want to show you. This is actually the freebie that you will be getting. Okay. So as you see, say you don't want to say raw vibrancy and say, we're just going to, say, I'm going to say, like revamp and reset your body in 24 hours, because maybe that is exactly what I decide. And again, you know, the whole idea of having an opt-in freebie is kind of making it align with what you need. So this is just a basic one, okay, real basic. You see, I downloaded that. What you want to do, and this is what you'll get, you're going to insert right here, what was your story? Why are you doing this? So for some of you on this, you're selling oils, you're selling makeup, you're selling lotions, you're selling creams you've made, you're selling your own services, you know, whatever you're selling. For me, you know, I create spring detoxes, and I also work with people one-on-one to do those detoxes. I do them live. So for this right now, I want this to be about that, because that's what I'm promoting right now. It could also be about, you know, the fact that I use like beauty counter sunscreen and that my face used to look like a surfer, but now it doesn't anymore because I actually found a sunscreen that doesn't have this pure white zinc oxide. It could be about essential oils because I love essential oils. It could be just about clean eating because who doesn't need some of that in their life? So what you're going to do is, you know, you could edit this however to your liking, put in cute little pictures. You could take pictures, you could add in more of your tips. The whole idea is that you want to say, here, this is my solution for you. So whether it's inserting the name of a detox program, whether you have a retreat, like, you know, or a group coming up that you want to promote, your ideas, you're using your opt-in to explain what it would be like to work with you. Put a picture of yourself. You can put testimonials. And these are great, great, just, you know, great sites that have very clear opt-in freebies. But make sure if you have like a few people that would, especially if you're a new coach, have a few people that would give you testimonials, especially if it's product-based, have those testimonials. So let's just pretend that I go in and I add, I'm going to have to move this. And I highly encourage you to always have something like this set up so that you can just go really easy. So I copy. So let's just, we won't take the testimonials right now, but we'll just do this. We're going to paste. So right there, and of course, I would edit this in. Now, this may take you a little, may take you not a little. Focus more just on the information that you want to actually get out there. And we're going to save this. Now, we would want to save this as a DOC or a DOCX because we want to have that material so we can go back. For the purpose of today, I'm going to save it as a PDF and call it Test Coach Rock Freebie, RF. And then we are going to put it on the desktop. And of course, we would always check it. You know, you always want to check your work. It's a big thing that I think is really, you know, especially with PDFs. So then you're going to, oh, crazy stuff going on here. All right, so right here, we're going to put that right into Dropbox. Now you can with MailChimp automatically have that and upload it. You could put it in Dropbox, but you need to have it, you need to store it somewhere. A lot of people always say, where do I put my list? This is MailChimp for me. So you can sign up for a free account. If you do it with what's called automation, where your list is then attached to a welcome letter. So once somebody puts in their name and they sign up, it triggers an automation letter to go out. You can do that. I'm going to show you the short and sweet, quick and sassy way, easy way to do it. List name. So we're going to call this Test Coach Freebie Rock RF 2015. Default email. Now, some of you have emails that are like info, and I did this for a long time. It used to go to my info at detox.rachelswellness.com, but now I actually love it going to my personal one because then people can actually reply right to me. Again, what is that enhancing? Communication. Some people would think that's not a good thing because access, some people believe is not, you know, the best thing for people to be able to have for you. But I like people being able to reply to me. I like to put cross street. Somebody was asking this in the Done For You spring program forum. They were saying, well, it's illegal not to give MailChimp or AWeber your permanent address. You have to give them your address, but you don't want your list going out to the world with your address. People are a little freaky these days. I'm not saying I don't want anyone having my address all the time. I don't mind my phone number. That's fine. So a short reminder. Now I have existing reminders, but just for the purpose of pretending that we're doing this brand new, say, you know, you are receiving, and they even give you an example, like you are receiving this email because you opted in for some goodness. and of course you can have, and I usually put at Rachel's Wellness for some greatness, and I always keep it very simple. I also in there say, you know, your email will not be shared. Your email is private. and will not be shared. Okay, then we go and we create the list. And again, you know, I always say this, you can, an opt-in freebie, it could be recipes, it could be a video, it could be a video series, you know, really start to think outside the box, because I think so often we get really stuck in this one area. So just want everyone to keep thinking as I'm talking, like, okay, what can I have there as an opt-in? What would I want an opt-in? You can have notifications daily, one by one. Just going to hit save. Okay. Now, this is when we go to sign up forms. This is the big part. Okay. We went to sign up forms, general forms. And right here, if I want to use an image, so right now I'll just actually, sorry, you can see how crazy my, let's just say that I want to do an opt-in with my spring banner for my detox. It always has to be 600 across, so just make sure that you're doing that. And of course, if you wanted to have an opt-in and you had the 3D, you could put that. If you wanted to, I would actually change this in PicMonkey to show the picture of the opt-in, and say, join, you know, thanks for downloading, join, you know, my spring detox program. You know, you can do a bunch of different things. You then are going to go back up. That was your sign up form. You then are going to go to your confirmation thank you page. So on this confirmation thank you page, that means they have opted in. Thank you for subscribing. So this is where we want to actually, and you know, choose your font. I like to use Arial a lot. Say, dear friend, I'm so excited you have taken a huge leap in your life by downloading this awesome freebie, this awesome e-guide on weight loss, healthy eating, and giving up the diet mayhem. I will also be sharing with you a simple 24-hour detox, plus all the ways I de-stress in this busy world. Then you say, click here to download. Now, this is something that took me forever to. If you want this to be hyperlinked, you are highlighting this, hyperlink. We go back. Oops, we go back. Share. Dropbox changed a little. So that is actually the link. This is going to be the link that you copy. For some people, may not show up highlighted. You can put this right in. I just want to show you that again. Now, the thing is, you can also do a file. So if you wanted to upload that file, you could do that. If there is an email address, such as like email me, so click here to download is going to be, say, you know, it has been a true pleasure. It's been a true pleasure, and I look forward to getting to know you. Now, you want to also in this include, you know, you may want to include an offering that's coming up, such as, you know, right now, like everyone and their mother's cleansing. I don't know who doesn't have a headache right now with, you know, the liver needing to cleanse at this time. This is probably one of the most important cleanses of the entire year, because if you don't cleanse out that liver, which has 500 metabolic jobs, you tend to see a lot of rashes in the summer, digestive issues, got immune issues, you name it, it happens. And that's why a lot of people are like a little aggressive right now, or you feel tired, because that's That's what happens when the liver is trying to detox. So I would let people know it's been a true pleasure getting to know you and that my upcoming detox is coming. And that if they wanted to know what detox is about, and it's not about just drinking juices and doing enemas and, you know, deprivation, that they could email me. And you can put this, and then you can say, you know, with love. And I like to go back to the bio. And you can copy. And that would have to be a different picture that we would actually do. And again, picture right here, you can upload. And then if you wanted to, of course, you know, you wanted to get colorful, just showing you this, for example, not that I would do red at this time of year, but it's kind of a little more summer. But you can change, you can make this, you know, larger so it's very clear for somebody. You could put a picture. So what you want to do is copy all of this and make it look pretty. You know, make it look nice. It's going to be the first thing that they're going to see, you know, when they come to working with you. And to downloading. And I like to also put it on this page as well, just as a double. This is just the simple, easy way. So as soon as somebody opts in to this specific list, they are going to get that. They are going to end up getting that, that specific download. So if you wanted to, you know, test, we could go and test that. The biggest thing also with automation, and I just want to show you this, is that automation is going to be linked to different specific emails. So what you want to make sure when you're doing MailChimp is that if you do create that list, you can put that very verbiage there. If you want to do an automation, that is where you have to have a paid account, and that is where you are going to create a nice, you know, letter, set it up. It actually says set up for automation. So if we wanted to create an automation, we would be able to create an automation workflow. And we'll just show you this. Select a list. Test coach. Welcome email, workflow name, test coach email 2005 rocket from my name. Then when do you want it to trigger? This is where everyone gets always like crazy. Segmented conditions, send first email to existing subscribers, trigger workflow when subscribers are imported. So this is also for everyone who does programs, like all my family and in the Done For You programs. You have this. This is so important because the moment that you put somebody's email, even if you're on Facebook and they say, "I want this," you can go in and manually put them in. Even if you don't know how to connect PayPal to a sales page, I hear this all the time. Rachel, I can't buy, you know, a detox or a program. I don't know how to connect it. Well, neither did I. I went in and manually, you know, added people's names and triggered that workflow for that first email. So we want to make sure that it's every day. And then here's your email. So add an email. Edit this email, and it will be welcome to your 24-hour revamp, and what do we call it? Reboot, reset, reset. From me, this will then we'll go to template. I have saved templates, so luckily it's just right here. Oops, sorry. Having one of those crazy nights. So I'll just go to this save template. But if you don't have a save template, put in a picture. Again, you want that picture to actually You want that picture to actually be 600 across, remember? This is actually when I was doing a sexy smoothie party. But then what we're going to do is we're going to edit it. So hi, friend, as we did. I am so excited you're here. And then we say, yada, 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 yada. And then we say, you know, click here to download. Oops, if I could spell. Download the goods. And then what do? We have that option again. Cover, go here. We could do the web address linking to Dropbox, or we could do the file. So that is what you're going to do. You're going to say, love, you know, Rachel Feldman, save and close. These are just boxes down here. So if I wanted to delete them, but this is a great place. If you want to, whatever you're promoting, essential oils at that time, I was promoting a sexy smoothie party, my blog. But let's just say that we are good to go. So we're finishing it up. So that is set. So then we go back to list. Where did we create this test? Okay. You get to see all really the back end of my good stuff. Then we want to add a subscriber. You can also import them. So if you are on another system right now, you just don't want to import people who don't want to be on your list. That's happened to me. And it's not fun because you get added to people's lists and it's actually not even legal to do that. So yes, it's saying that they have opted in, they've subscribed. And then what's going to happen is I'm then going to get that email coming in saying that I've subscribed. And again, what I can also do, and I just want to show you from this list, because a lot of people ask this. Okay, so from this list, and this is what we'll even end with before we have questions, sign up forms, general forms. This is what you share on social media. So whether you want to bit.ly that or mask it and change the name, this is what you share. That's number one, because everyone always says, where do I share it? When it comes to the different forms, if you wanted to embed the form, this would be the HTML code that you would get. So here, just to even show you, subscribe to our mailing list. This would be it. Then you would grab this HTML code. So if you have an IN site, and you want that little subscribe to my mailing list, that's where you would put. If you have a Wix and you need to grab the HTML or Weebly or anything. So the bottom line is there's no excuse to getting your stuff out there. Because yes, does it look like that's hard? But I've done that in 15 minutes flat in the morning. Just walking you guys through it can take a little longer. And like I said, I'm no tech person. Somebody once told me, you shouldn't do these kind of classes. You're not a tech person. And I thought, well, you know what? I don't think like a tech person. I think like a person trying to get it done. So for me, they are very helpful. And I hope that you enjoyed this class. Does anyone have a question? No? So the biggest thing that I want to leave you with is that people don't just sign up because you say, sign up for my free opt-in. People sign up because you have shared something that has touched them and they feel something. They have a moment of connection with you and then they sign up. So no matter what you're offering, no matter what you're selling, you know, I think the best people who sell are the ones that don't even know that they're selling. Of course, do I know that, you know, I need to sell done free programs for health coaches? Do I know that I need to sell programs, online programs for my clients and that I need to do health histories and work with my one-on-one clients? Of course I do. But the moment that I get into that, like, you know, just ego-based, like, you know, stuff where I'm like, sign up, my business just stops. And the moment that I step back and and I have fun and I want to really be there to help other people, you know, things really flow in my life and my business. So with that being said, think about what's coming up for you. Think about what you want to offer or what you desire to offer, because, and think about how you can use this, an opt-in, any different kinds, you know, every different format to really build your business and expand it in a way that's cohesive with your message and your niche, your avatar, as well as your plan. You know, when I work with people one-on-one, coaches, I really talk about like, what is the plan? And even though it's scary to build a business, you know, month one of working with coaches, you know, it's always kind of scary. Like you don't know what to do, but once you master the art of uncomfortableness and you know that you can launch a program, you know that you can launch a freebie and you build your list and get that first people to sign up. And then all of a sudden you have a list and you get 300 people on that list. That's exciting. Because if you know of the conversion is about 3%, you need to have a pretty good list, because not everyone opens up an email and not everyone's going to enjoy you. You know, you're going to find those people who really enjoy you. There are tons of people in this world who don't like me. And then there are tons of people who do like me, whether it's coaches or clients. You have to find your tribe, and you will find your tribe, but you have to be able to let them know how you communicate, what you're trying to say, and what your real mission is and your message. Because if they don't know, or if you don't know, they're really not going to know. But also use opt-in freebies to figure out what people do want to hear from you. So does anyone have a question before we wrap up? Speak now or forever hold your peace. Anybody? Oh, we have a few questions. Okay, so how often, oh, these are great questions. Oh, sorry, I saw all the ones at the top, like yes, yes. Okay, can you create an opt-in freebie in lead pages? Yeah, you can totally do lead pages. It's very effective, actually, lead pages have been shown, because you have to think of like a horse with blinders on. And I see a few even of people I work with on the phone tonight. So I want to say to them, yes, this is exactly what I tell you. You want to have your clients really have one focus, even if it's an email, one focus, a newsletter, a blog post. Lead pages is a great example of that, where you can really say, you know, sign up for this, you know, amazing ebook. And that is just the only focus on these pages. And I think that there are a few different ones that are free. And also a great way to just have a really sparkling, nice, you know, it's called a squeeze page, where they're just opting in on that one page. And I actually have a few pages that are just opt-in pages. So that's a great question, CJ. Yeah, for sure. All right. So can you upload on MailChimp? 100%. You can upload a file onto MailChimp. You just don't want to upload tons of files because it just takes up space. So if you are uploading one ebook, for sure, I would say yes. Upload an ebook. I wouldn't necessarily upload like 7 documents from a detox onto MailChimp. I don't know if it's a better or worse about Dropbox. The one thing that's tricky with Dropbox, and oh man, have I learned this over the years, Dropbox, just like any other company, will do security updates. They used to, many years ago, send out an update letting you know that your links were going to be broken and they were updating. But I think with the amount of hacking, like in the last few years, and people really trying to hack into Dropbox and trying to hack into some of these major companies, they don't let anyone know that their links will be broken. So sometimes you do want to actually upload the file. It's really great. If you find that you have a broken link, just go in and create a new folder with that PDF, or copy it and create a new link. Okay. Where will I be in Sedona? I'm speaking at the Pure Living Expo. I just got asked. What an honor. And talk about opt-in freebies, because this is such a great example. When I built this business, I built it with like two babies on the floor. I mean, I moved to Florida and my kids weren't even 2 and 4. And so I didn't have time to go to events. And even with them growing up, that wasn't an option. I had to build my business from right here, sitting in my office on my computer. In my first teleclass, I had 3 people, which was, you know, very different from what it is today, but I didn't give up, which is point number one. Point number two is that all of my opt-in freebies, my programs, my detoxes, they create not only credibility, but they've given me confidence as well. There was always confidence in what I knew, but not in a system. And so I actually was asked to come and speak at the True Living Expo in Sedona. So I'll be there in July. So if you are in Sedona in July, somebody was asking me where I'm going to be. But your opt-in freebies start to give you these opportunities because other people start to see what you're doing and they download your stuff. I've had people who say, I have followed you for years. Years. That means they have downloaded every opt-in freebie I've done. They've downloaded everything. So do not think that somebody's not reading it. Yes, you will be able, I will be sending out this, I'll be sending out this recording. Somebody is asking if they can listen again. How often should you post? That's a great question. You know, I don't have, and you're going to have to see your list and who you attract. I don't have people that like to be sold to. So I can't post often, like sign up for my detox. and I don't even on my personal page post about the Done For You programs because I don't have a lot of people that like those hard sells. I find, people know what I'm about. They know what they can get. But you do have to market. I like at the bottom of every post on my business page, which links to Twitter. Also I will put my opt-in freebie. I will also put my opt-in freebie usually once a day on my personal page. I will add my business site, www.rachelswellness.com, or I will say download this opt-in freebie. But you want to be posting throughout the day because, again, that's content and trust building. It's a great – okay. Lost me on the confirmation page. You did a copy all. Not a problem. You will be getting this, but on the confirmation page, what I copied was just the link to Dropbox. Again, you can upload that file and it's not a problem. So you have two options, uploading the file. What if my freebie is not good enough, having trouble deciding on the freebie? Is that the question? I don't think it's about good enough. I think it's about really believing that we have something to offer. And if you don't know how to write a freebie, if you don't feel like you have what you need in your program or in your business, that is for me why, you know, the Done For You programs have been life changing. And for most of the coaches who get it, not all, some coaches have, you know, a lot of problems, you know, getting their stuff out there. And that's just life, you know, that's business. That's owning our own business. But freebies can be very simple. Make it personal. Make it like someone's talking to you so they feel you. People always say to me, God, I can go to your site and I just feel you. And that means that, okay, that's a good thing. Like, you know, I've probably said like 150 times during this conversation, but that's part of who I am. So don't think that your freebie isn't good enough. And you're also going to get this free one that I'm giving you because I want you to succeed. The world needs us. So don't think of that. If I have a freebie opt-in, had 1 to 2 people sign up, is that what is a good invite that's exciting and will draw people in? You know, I think when we only have 1 to 2 people showing up, one, we may want to change the name of the opt-in. 2, you want to market in a different way. You know, say, hey, if you come, you know, if when you download this, you know, the 10th person might get this free X. Maybe they get, you know, a strategy session with you. Make it fun. You know, make your business fun. I think so often, and I felt this over the years, I was scared. I was uncomfortable. I was nervous. I even get that nervous Nelly stuff still these days, thinking nobody's going to come. But, you know, it's just about having fun with it. And so when people feel your excitement about what you do, it's contagious. And I would say if you have an opt-in freebie that only 1 to 2 people are signing up, not only change the name, test it out by putting different keywords, keywords that have to do with your niche, keywords that have to do with your marketing. And this is something that I work on a lot when I teach, what are those key specific words? When I work with people one-on-one, I say, write down these 5 words that you have to consistently use in your marketing. I'm so happy that somebody said that you feel this was really helpful. Leaving Constant Contact for me was a paralyzing moment as well. I thought, how am I ever going to do this? And I learned how to do MailChimp, and it's like I love MailChimp because it really allows you to track. It also allows you to create more automation, more follow-ups. I just think it's great. Can you build a list with guest posting? Yes, you could totally build a list with guest posting. If you wanted to do guest posting at the end of the guest post, say, you know, download, you know, if you love this blog, download this, this opt-in freebie. The other thing with guest posting, I'm about to do a whole guest posting as well, is you can almost do it in a way where people have to share your opt-in freebie. And so you can create anything to be list builders. Where should we put this wonderfully built thing? If we have a great opt-in, then what? Once you have this great opt-in, you want to share it on Facebook, you want to share it on Twitter, you want to share it on different social media. You also can give it as a thank you for people coming to events, just like I'm giving you a thank you for coming to my event. And this is just like, I mean, this is not even, I'm not saying this isn't a good freebie, but the freebies that we put together in the Done For You programs, I mean, they're sick. Like sick when I tell you, they tell an entire story. They give problems, solutions, whys. So, you know, if you're sitting there feeling like, oh God, I'm just completely frazzled and I have no time, I hope this helps you out. And if you need some more help, you can email me and ask me about the Done For You programs and what they're like and all that jazz. What's a good way to get people to sign up for your opt-in? You know, that's a great question. I think number one is really qualifying yourself as a health coach. I see too many people that have either come out of school, come out of multiple schools, and they're still posting. And I love animals, but they're still posting about like animals on their personal page or their business page. You want to get very clear with people that they know you're the person to talk to about health, that like you love it, you dig it, you may not be perfect. But you can say, you know what, I'm so excited. I just put together this awesome guide. You don't even have to say anything else because that is part of marketing, like teasing them, because it's like, oh, well, what is this guide? What if I don't download it? Will my life end? That's marketing. So I think, letting people see that you have a site, putting it on your site, putting it on Facebook, And being proud of it. You know, I think that's a part of something that we really, really forget, like, you know, to be proud of our stuff and that people are friends and our family and other people. And to say to someone, you know, look, you're a friend of mine. Do you mind supporting or sharing this? And I'm not that good, to be honest, at asking people to do things like that. I'm kind of a lone wolf when it comes to doing my own stuff. But I get asked all the time, like, can you share this? Can you do this? And I do, and I'm very happy to. But you can have people, you know, say, I've just put this together, or I'm going to be launching a program, and, you know, I'm hosting a challenge, and, you know, or this is 3 days of how to eat healthy, or this is 2 days, whatever it is, getting people excited. I do create specific distributions lists for everything. I have tons of different lists, and I then export them into a general list. But you can get very specific and just communicate with that one list. Thanks so much for downloading, you know, my 21-day smoothie ebook. I'm so happy that you enjoyed it. Like, smoothies really helped me with my digestive, you know, stuff and my autoimmune. If you want to have a strategy session and really creating that follow up. So someone says, I have a list with 200 people, but I've yet to use my Vistaprint email when they sign up. How do I all of a sudden approach or send out emails to start a campaign without them thinking, why is he taking so long? Who cares that we took long? So what? Maybe we were in the bathroom for a little too long and we didn't get out of the bathroom. You know, welcome to what everyone thinks in the world. Like, this person did it. There's never a too late. If you have people, if there's 200 people, that's 200 people you're about to communicate with, and get really authentic and say, you know what? It's taken me a while to communicate with you guys. And I've been so busy and I've been up to some really rad stuff. Of course, this is my verbiage. But I wanted to share with you what's been happening. And so, you know, don't think it's lost time. Lost time is having our dreams go to us to the grave. That's lost time. So instead, think of it as, you know, what am I communicating and what do I actually want to say to these people? And what is, so for you who has the 200, what are you offering? What are you going to give them? Do you have, you know, a program that you're launching? Is it your work with me? You know, really think about what you want to talk to them about in this great email. I know for a lot of people, and I've worked with coaches who had zero lists, and literally we just built consistently every day. And that's how I built my list. I built it because I consistently every day did the same thing. So procrastination for a lot of people comes from fear. We just don't know what to do. And that's why I'm going to do this. And then I'm actually going to do a series of these kind of things. This is going to kind of be part of a new program that I'm putting together, even on just like a series of classes like this. Like, how do I get started from the ground up? No fluff, no like, you know, confusing multiple things, like really the nitty gritty like this in classes, because I really think this is what we all need. This is what I needed. How long does it take to do a campaign in MailChimp for the first time? The biggest thing that I will say is it's not the length of the campaign that takes time. It's choosing the top banner, the picture, which I will do that on another time. I should do a whole class on PicMonkey. It's choosing banner 600 across. It will then do the right height. And then it's just deciding your font. If you do want to spend money, whether it's Fiverr, Elance, Odesk, any of these, or you do have a designer that will make you a template that will just make your life easier, you just then have that saved template. But that's really it. Once you have a template, you're good to go. And even if you don't have a template, which I could do that class as well, it's just about getting a picture in, writing it, and then deciding the list it goes to, and then hitting send. Really, just saying screw it and hit send. So I just want to say thank you so much. We had an awesome time tonight, and I hope that everyone did. If you're feeling stuck in your business, and I say this like really from the bottom of my heart, if you're feeling scared, I get scared too. I had like a day like that today. It was like, just the negative Nelly. She woke up and I wasn't able to work out and crush her to the floor. But you know, that's the part of building a business. So if you feel like you're procrastinated, if you feel like you don't know what to do, yeah, welcome to owning a business. You know, that is how we feel, which is why we either get a coach, and if we can't afford a coach, we find a community of people, which is why I love the Done For You programs, because the community of people. Or we just find support. So no matter what, like, I believe in our ability within all of us to turn on that switch and make it happen. Did it take me 15 hours when I first signed up for MailChimp to figure that out? Hell yeah. It took me a lot of time, and it took me many building of websites and tiers and all of that. And that's why I don't want you to have the blood, sweat, and tears. So if you do want to check out, you know, these are the programs that I offer. We do payment plans. I think that they're pretty rad. So you can go to detox.rachelswellness. You're also going to get your freebie. And I just hope this was like an awesome, awesome time. So thank you so much, guys. I will talk to you soon. Does anyone have any more questions? Nope. All right. Lots of love. And I will talk to you guys soon. Have an amazing, amazing night. Take care of yourself. I think when we're health coaches, even if you take 5 minutes, rub coconut oil on your feet, shove some in your mouth to coat your myelin sheath, which calms the nervous system in the brain. Well, it's the myelin sheath is in the brain, so it calms the nervous system. Just do something really good for yourself. And sometimes we only get 5 minutes because that's just life and building a business. But I care about all of you, and I hope that you have an awesome day, night, whichever it is, in whatever part of the world you are. So, and if you have any questions, you can always reach me via my site, everything. I answer my own emails. I try to, even though sometimes I wake up to 300. But I care about you all, and I believe in you all, and that's about it. Rock it out, and I will see you soon. Bye, guys.